Now broadcasting and streaming live from 7 Broadcast Plaza, this is 7 Eyewitness News at 11.
8.5 months after the Buffalo Bills walked off the field in Kansas City disappointed, they're getting ready for their chance at redemption. Good evening, everyone. The Bills will face the Kansas City Chiefs for the third time in the last year, and this could go a long way towards showing if the Bills are legitimate Super Bowl contenders. Our Adam Unger joins us now as the Bills get ready to face something of a big brother, Adam.
Yeah, big bro, so to speak, has gotten the best of the Bills so far in the last calendar year. But don't forget, back in 2017, Sean McDermott able to take down Andy Reid with Tyrod Taylor and Alex Smith as those two quarterbacks. A lot has changed since then, though. The consistency, though, like we've said, Kansas City coming out on top. It was more of a narrow win in week 6 of last year, 26-17, the final in that one, with Travis Kelce scoring Kansas City's only 2 touchdowns. And when they met again in January, Kansas City able to completely erase a slow start. They went on a 31-6 run from the end of the first quarter to the middle of the fourth quarter, 38-24 en route to repeating as AFC champs. But left tackle Deion Dawkins thinks these two teams are on even ground.
A competitive type of environment, like almost like having like two brothers that fight. This is kind of like what it is, you know. Like they're a great team. We're a great team, and I would say that we're twins. You know, like we're born at the same time, identical. Just we have blue, they have red. I have blue eyes, they have red eyes.
Evil red eyes for Kansas City and the Chiefs. And Jeff, we heard it from these guys all week. The McDermottisms don't quite apply based on how last season ended. And coming up later in sports, we're going to show you how a rookie for Buffalo is feeling different going into this one as well, along with the bill of health as the Bills gear up for their biggest game so far this season. For now, we'll send it back over to you.
All right, thank you, Adam. Big time matchup, and a lot of Bills fans have already made the trip to Kansas City. Many more will head there this weekend. They're going to find plenty of friendly faces when they get there as well. We introduced you to Al Burns before the AFC Championship game in January. He owns Al's Bar and Grill. It's about 20 miles away from Arrowhead Stadium. Burns is a South Buffalo native and brought a taste of Buffalo to the Show Me State. He expects his place to be packed all weekend.
It's already started. Buffalo people are coming in and just sharing stories, locations and Buffalo people and all this. I'm homesick.
Well, Burns says he's followed the team since the beginning in 1960. He loves his fellow fans, saying one fan, in fact, gave him a signed Jim Kelly jersey. Well, fans who will be watching here in Western New York can meet at another block party. Chippewa Street going to be open on Sunday night between Delaware and Franklin. More than 700 fans went to a block party for the Miami game 3 weeks ago. City leaders expect at least twice as many people for this big Sunday night showdown.
And the reaction's been really great. People have been embracing these Bills games. Obviously the Bills are great this year, so when the Bills are good, all the businesses seem to kind of cash in on that and the city is very supportive, and that's what we're hoping for this event and carrying that through November and December.
Well, tickets start at $10 a pop. Parties are also planned for November 14th and December 26th. Our Andy Parker, looking at it all tonight, joins us now with what the weather will be for the people who want to watch the game downtown this weekend. Andy?
Hey, it is coming up at the middle of October. You got to ask your question. Is it going to be okay to be outside? This time of year can swing either way. Take a look at the graphic. And I think we win the weather battle with Kansas City. We'll have to see how the football game works out. On the left, Kansas City, Missouri. You have a good looking downtown. On the right hand side, there you can see City Hall and the Seneca Tower. Let's go ahead and look at the forecast for the game time. Now, the game is played in Kansas City. It's going to be about 73 at kickoff. Showers will be arriving during the course of the game. So those folks start out dry and then it turns wet. We'll have to see how wet as we get a little closer. And then here back in Buffalo to watch the game, 8 o'clock, it's 70 degrees outside, slowly dropping into the 60s under partly cloudy skies and no wind either. You can't ask for much more than that here in Buffalo, New York, to watch a Sunday night primetime game. Of course, there's more to the weekend than just Sunday. I'm going to walk you through kind of a soggy Saturday and a record-setting Monday. All of that straight ahead.